Dog Nation's Next Generation series is brought to you by Pella Window and Door of Georgia. Pella. Any style, any home, any budget. Visit PellaofGA.com to get started.
Hello, Dog Nation, and welcome back. I'm Kaylee Mansell with Jess and Tell. And hey, we finally got to change clothes for you guys today. So excited about that, but more excited to give you some information on the next generation of talent headed to Athens. Today, we are going to be talking about wide receiver Yazeed Haynes, the nation's number 27 wide receiver overall out of Fort Washington, Pennsylvania. He was an early enrollee, Jess. So talk about what he showed early on in these winter workouts and spring drills.
Yeah, I kind of feel freed up, don't you, Kaylee? I don't have the tie. I got a stuffy studio. So like, we're just going to talk around friends with Dog Nation right here. So it's kind of sneaky. Everybody thought that, you know, Yazeed was going to be, oh, yeah, real good piece, former three-star, was committed to Rutgers, was committed to Penn State, and then chose Georgia. But, like, he's kind of sneakily, Kaylee, might wind up being the best receiver in the class.
Wow.
The OG wide receiver, TEWR, Terrence Edwards, wide receiver academy. Now, he'd seen that film, and then he's also saw him, you know, those big alumni lettermen. They get to sneak in. Kirby will let him in for a practice or two during the spring, and he was impressed. He used this term, and I would tell you, you guys remember when we did this with Justin Jefferson and A.D. Mitchell a few years ago with Terrence Edwards. He used the term Devonta Smith. Wow. To describe what he saw out of Yazeed Haynes. And, you know, Haynes is a guy that, you know, we talked about how he was a three-star. I think he was number 600 overall or something like that. And then he, like, burst. I don't think it was the Georgia bump so much as, well, that is a real thing. But I think it was they saw his film and they're like, dadgum, this guy's good. And you can tell it's a good player when it gets me acting a little too Southern and saying dadgum. He's a guy that, you know, has the burst and the twitch, but he's also got really serious route running skills, which is a deadly combination in the SEC.
Now, I know you just touched on a couple of these things, but obviously this is a very talented 2023 class. So, but how has he been a surprise so far to you, Jeff?
Yeah, that's kind of what it is. I mean, Tyler Williams is great. That was the highest rated guy that everybody thought would be the X receiver, the outside receiver. And nothing against Tyler. He enrolled early, and you got Anthony Evans, the third, a guy that has 10.3 speed in the 100 and can long jump 24, 25 feet. And all of a sudden, though, you see Yazeed Haynes. You heard about him in spring practice. It wasn't just one flash or two flashes. He was kind of making it go, turning a lot of heads all spring, and then he gets into G-Day, makes a big catch. Everybody remember that when he makes the big catch, and his helmet lid flips off, and then he runs back to the huddle. And this is a guy that, you know, the path to Georgia having dangerous men, like explosive dudes out at receiver, the way that Ohio State does and the way that Alabama has for so many years, it's guys like Yazeed Haynes, who I think he can play outside, he can play a lot of positions, but he also has, get this, I can't believe I've waited this long to say this, he has 4.39 speed in the 40, and he never ran track, and he's like, yeah, you know, I got to get faster. I'm not really fast enough. So when a guy's hitting low 4.4, sub 4.4 in the 40, and he's like, I got to run a little bit faster. That's when you know you have a really fast man.
Now, one thing that I think is very interesting about him in particular is that before he committed to UGA, he was the nation's 601st player overall, but once he committed, he became a top 200 prospect. How do you explain that?
Yeah, so it really is funny. It's early on, Kaylee, you know, he was committed to Rutgers, and then he's like, oh, here comes Penn State. And they're like, wow, look what we found. And Penn State wasn't sure whether he was a DB or a wide receiver. And then Yazeed starts going to camps. Give credit for Rivals. They had him as a four-star first.
What?
And that was because he went to one of their camps. Like, he didn't go to, like, a lot of the Under Armour things. He didn't get seen a lot. But when he did get seen, everybody's like, this guy can really roll. And he's got that route tree as well. And then really once – and kind of the Georgia commitment kind of showed the world that, okay, hold on. Georgia wants this guy, and they're taking him in July as a receiver. Then you know him, they know he must be pretty good. But then you saw his senior year. You saw what he did on film, put up 1,000 yards, lots of touchdowns, lots of explosive plays and yards per catch. And I think what you're seeing, it kind of repetition now, deja vu in the 2024 class, they find a guy like Nitro Showtime Tuggle, who was a three-star, and Georgia was in on him early. You know, shout out to BMAC on this one. It's kind of what you have here with Yazeed Haynes. I think he got all the way up to 199, 196 for 24/7 Sports. But then those good folks over at On3, they actually have him as the number 108 overall prospect in the country. They think a little bit more of him right there. And really, rankings are great, but when the guys are in Athens and their own campus and you hear them balling out and you see them getting in G-Day and you see them with that kind of scary speed that can do a lot of things for Mike Bobo's offense now in Athens, bodes well for the future.
Well, one thing that I love that we've done throughout this entire series is touch on the stories behind the athletes. How did they get there? What's the real story behind this guy?
Yeah, there's a lot of them. First of all, he's got a lot of family. And he always says, I got to make it far in football. I got to go far in football. And that's for his family. And one of the things that motivated him in high school is he lost an older brother at the tender age of 18. It was due to violence. It was something senseless. And what Yazeed does for Shahid Haynes is he will write his name on his tape, on his wrist, on his gear. And he always think of him. And he thinks about, you know, my brother would love to be alive right now. My loved brother would have loved to lived out his dream. So that's why I got to go as far as I can in the game of football. Really sincere young man. I love it. I love it, Kaylee. I have so much stuff on this, and I'm sitting here under one of our last Q&A topics. And the young man also has a 4.2 GPA. So, I mean, you've got motivation, you got pure speed, you got the route tree, you got Terrence Edwards giving him a big DawgNation thumbs up, and you got a 2.GPA, and he's definitely got a huge why and a will to be great in football. And now he's in Athens, and you guys get to enjoy seeing him for maybe only about 3 years. That's how good this young man's going to be.
Well, Jeff, it sounds like he has all the factors that he needs to might be the best wide receiver to come out of this class. I'm excited to hold you to that statement over the next 3 years. Guys, once again, thank you for joining in. We will see you right back here next week telling you all about the next generation of talent headed to Athens.